As Carsten said, we have annually we have a programming project for computer science students, and we give them some project related. Mostly, we give them project related to JSXGraph in some way, and of course, they have 1 semester time to work on it. But in most cases, they get some kind of prototype, but sometimes something comes out and it's close to be production ready. So the plan is now to have these projects and put them on GitHub, especially to be specific, on JSXGraph GitHub.io, and maybe people jump on it, and together we are able to make them production ready. So for these projects, help is very welcome, from pull requests, bug reports, suggestions, everything is welcome. And we will give a few examples below. So the first, and before I start, I must admit I'm not a really I'm not really sure how we could use GitHub.io. So at the moment we use it in two different ways. We have this project JSON2D, and then below you see graph theory. And so JSON2D is a separate GitHub project, and graph theory at the moment is a project inside of this JSX GitHub.io. So this is just a management issue or administration issue. But maybe you can give us hints how to do it the best way. Yeah, so let's start. What do this project do? So JSON2D was a feature request by someone in the JSX of GitHub repository. Namely, this guy requested the JSON2D graphics interface for JSXGraph. And to make things short, I show it to you. So this is the GitHub page. And so obviously there are some computer algebra systems, MathX, Simya, and Wolfram. And of course, there's a close relationship to Sylvester from the talk before. And these three systems, they apparently have an interface or an export possibility for graphics using JSON. The feature request was that JSX that we should have a JSON import interface for JSXGraph. And here's an example. So it's also some kind of, so it's a Simya. So it's also some kind of notebook. And there's a plot command. And this plot command in this computer algebra system produces a plot. So it produces data points, and this data point should be exported to JSXGraph via JSON, and JSXGraph displays these plots. Yeah, and it works. And yeah, so if you want to use it, you can use it, and that you can clone this, or you can take it from this GitHub project if it's something for your project. So far, I see one. I'm not really satisfied with it so far, because it's only one way. So of course, this computer algebra systems, these computer algebra systems, they want to do the math so to say. And all they do the math and they produce some visualization, and JSXGraph does the plotting, so to say. But there's no bidirectional interface, though dragging something, you may allow it, but it doesn't have an effect on the math in the computer algebra system, though there's no way back. But maybe people think about it and find a clever way, though the computer algebra system can take input from JSXGraph again. Yeah. Okay, so this is this JSON2D interface. And last summer we had a project. We started a project doing graph theory in JSXGraph. And so we provided a very basic starter package, how to represent graphs with JSXGraph. And the students did implemented some placement algorithms, like a random placement, circular placement, force-directed placement, tree placement. So far, the only supported graph input format is the Dimex Bliss format, but it should be very easy to implement different input formats. So let me show you what we have so far. So here's the very basic JSXGraph GitHub page. And here are the graph theory algorithms. So here's a base example, a little bit too large. And you do some, this is a graph represented in JSXGraph. And it's loaded from some file and it's randomly placed on the board. So we can also take another one like this, or this, or this. Oop. Okay. So this is not really a very sophisticated placement. So a few words about the input format. Though this is from Michael Crick's homepage. Some examples. This is so-called Dimex Bliss format. It looks exactly like this, the marked input. So we have some comment lines, and then the number, there's a line with the number of points, namely in this case 11, and the number of edges, in this case it's 20, and then follow the edges. So it's a simple graph, edges between certain vertices. And this is it for the moment. There is one enhancement, namely colors. Colors are implemented by the line N, marked with an N. So here, vertice number one receives color one. Okay. And we store this as text in an array, and this is parsed. And the parsing is also that the JSXGraph code for this is the JavaScript code is very, very simple. Here's the whole base class. It parses. The main thing is to parse the Dimex format, and you can set an adjacency matrix and then the position and so on. It's more fun to look at the placements which have been done by the students. So this is a force-directed placement, though there are known algorithms from the literature, Eders and Fruchtermann, Rheingold, for example, and you can, it's still too large, you can start, for example, this Eders algorithm, and it's placed. So there's a spring model between the vertices, so non-adjacent vertices tend to go apart from each other, and adjacent vertices tend to attract themselves. Yeah, another one. Let's say the Peterson graph. And some small graphs, although it's complete graph, and so on. You can play around. You can play with these things, for example, a ring. And Fruchtermann does a little bit different algorithm. Yeah. And yeah, you can play with them. Okay, and yeah, this is tree placement. And then this is force-directed placement. And then we have algorithm for tree placement, so trees. And the question is, a tree, a graph without cycles may have different roots. And so we can take different roots like this and have different placements, horizontal, vertical, and also concentric, which is, example 4, it does not work, it's not a tree. Yeah, okay. Yeah, this is, these are initial projects. Probably much more can be made out of them, and hopefully you will jump on it and try to use it. And maybe the plan is to improve on this graph theory algorithms and make them available as a library on top of JSXGraph Core. So not to include it, but to provide it as a separate add-on library. Okay, this is graph theory. And the next thing is JSXGraph Author. This software has a long history going back to Slovenia. So we had a project with Slovenia. There was a project using JSXGraph in Slovenia, and they produced a small authoring tool for teachers to create JSXGraph construction. Though this project goes into the direction of Cyril and Ivan's talk yesterday, but it's not as sophisticated as their tool. So, what is it? So it's a the Slovenians in Slovenia, there was a first version and it was lying around, and now we took it up and improved the interface a little bit, but it's still not complete, so there's still a lot of work to do. So the spirit of this project is it's an interface for authoring JSXGraph constructions on a desktop computer, not on a mobile device, on a desktop computer. and then be able to export it as JSXGraph code. So for example, you can have a point or a line to intersections and have a circle. Yeah, this was, and of course you can drag around and yeah, and so on. So polygons and so on, and in the end you can download the SVG code or the PNG code or the JavaScript code. And I just want to show it to you. It's a little bit, don't get frightened by it. This is the JSX stuff code of this construction. It's terrible because it uses all, it displays for each element all available attributes. And this has to be changed in inside of JavaScript, of JSXGraph, to just export the difference between the defaults and the elements. So this tool exists. It's available on JSX on GitHub.io. You can use it, and we gradually, hopefully, we will gradually improve it. Yeah, these are the actual student projects. In the next winter, we will hopefully have students in the coming winter term. We will hopefully have students working on which will improve the access, the available coordinate systems in JSXGraph.